evening. Welcome to Drama and Dessert. Tonight we have a program of great variety, surprises, new things we are trying. We're very pleased to have our new curtains, which the park has helped us buy with 50-50 money. We're starting with a story that is true and really happened in the last 2 years in our country, Canada, and Europe. It begins in Canada, in the province of Nova Scotia. It is summer in the year of 2014. Our lead performer is a very unusual character, Hitchbop.
Hello, I am Hitchbop, a robot. I was created in Port Credit, Ontario, Canada, as an experiment. I am proud to be a part of a social experiment. Two university professors want to test the reactions of humans to robots. They are asking the question, can robots trust humans? It is July 27th, and I'm getting ready to travel across Canada. Since robots cannot drive in Canada, I'll have to hitchhike and depend upon the kindness of strangers to take me on my travels.
Hello, are you waiting for a ride to somewhere?
Yes, please. I want to see the sights in Halifax, Nova Scotia, including the museum about the sinking of the Titanic.
Well, I can take you that way. I happen to be going to Halifax, so hop right in.
You'll have to put me in your car, because I cannot move unless you pick me up.
Well, okay. Are you ready, and do I need to strap in or anything?
Oh, yes, please do. My humans want me to be safe. Thank you.
Oh, you're interested in that Titanic?
Yes, I am. That was a very sad event. And there were other things to see in Halifax also.
Well, I can get you to the museum, and then you'll have to ask others to help you out.
Good. I hope there will be other humans who want to help me.
Well, there probably will be. If you're able to tell them what you want and what you want to see.
Well, I can do that. I can also take pictures and send them back home as I travel. My family of humans lives in Ontario. They want to know how I'm doing.
Well, that really is amazing. I did not know what they could do with robots these days.
Yes, they can. They will post my pictures on the internet so that others can see how I am doing also. There are many other humans who want to know about my travels.
Well, how do you feel about humans? Do you feel they can be trusted?
Oh, yes, I think so. They are kind and helpful. They will get me to the places I want to see, and I hope to make new friends along the way.
Well, here we are. And this is as far as I can take you. I'm gonna drop you off right outside the museum here, and you can let them know what you want to see.
Thank you for much for bringing me this far. Good luck on the rest of your travels.
Well, you are welcome and safe journey. I'll just sit there and I'll try and get you out. Wow, that museum was great. And I also liked the museum about the Titanic. I wonder how long I'll be able to wait for my next ride.
In or anything special?
Oh yes, I do, to be safe.
Okay, hold on.
I guess my wife will have to ride in the back seat.
Take a picture of you from my scrapbook, I can send it to my humans at my home.
What will happen to the picture after you take it?
It will be posted on Twitter. I have hundreds of fans who want to know about my travels and what I'm doing.
Well, I guess that's all right. This is quite an adventure, isn't it?
Yes, I'm very excited about it.
What's your final destination, Hitch?
I hope to hitchhike clear across Canada to Victoria and see as much of the country as I can in my travels. I've been meeting some very nice people along the way.
That's a very ambitious plan, eh? It's almost 4,000 miles across. How long do you think it's going to take you?
Oh, I do not know. It depends on the kindness of strangers I meet along the way. The countryside is so green and nice.
It is beautiful.
Can I take a few more pictures to send back?
Sure, it's the best way to remember the trip.
Yes, my humans want me to take a lot of pictures.
Well, this is as far as we can take you. We're at the park and we're going to go in and camp for the night. Are you going to be all right out here on the road?
Sure, I may get picked up tonight and get another ride further along the way.
Well, working with you and traveling with you. Good luck.
Yeah.
Bye. See you later.
Thank you. I do not know how long I will have to wait now. The sun is beginning to set. I need the sun for my solar panels. But I do have a cord that can recharge me from the car if I get a ride at night.
Hey, hello there. Are you heading out west? Do you need a ride?
Yes. Are you going to the west?
Yes, I am. Are you the robot I saw on TV the other night? I never thought I'd meet you.
I suppose so. As far as I know, I'm the only robot hitchhiking across Canada.
Well, we have a long ride ahead of us, so might as well strap you into the car.
Thank you.
Are you ready?
Yes, I am. You said we have a long ride ahead of us.
Yes, we are.
Would you like to have a conversation? I can converse about many things.
You can? Like what kind of things?
Well, my home is in Ontario. I have many hobbies. I love baking, watching soccer and hockey. I have an interest in the humanities, in the natural sciences, and history and geography. I'm hoping to get a lot of good pictures on my trip as I travel.
Where did you learn all this information?
All of Wikipedia was downloaded onto my hard drive. I can talk about almost anything.
Oh, I see. That's a lot of information to have on your hard drive.
Yes, I know it is. It's good to have things you can talk about. Do you know the origin of the universe? What is your favorite hockey team?
Actually, it's the Montreal Canadiens. But as far as the origin of the Earth, I'm not sure. Can you be quiet for a little while I concentrate on your GPS?
Yeah, I guess I could do that. I understand you want some silence.
At your final destination in Victoria, what do you plan to see?
It is the Open Space Gallery. I'm very interested in the origin of the universe. The Space Gallery might be the place to learn more about that.
Oh, I see. Well, this is the right road to get you there eventually, but there's a lot of miles in between. I am going to have to turn north in a little while. Can I just leave you on the side of the road up there? But do you think you can get another ride?
I'm sure that'll be all right. People have been very kind.
Thank you.
Destination, and that is the road I have to take.
You're that robot I've been hearing about. You need a ride, eh?
Yeah. Are you going towards Victoria?
Yes, I'm going in that general direction. I'll get you in the car. Oh, by the way, my name's Judy. It's nice to meet you.
Hi, Judy. I've been traveling a while now and meeting a lot of people. I got invited to a wedding in Saskatchewan. That was a lot of fun. No, I just met them. One of my drivers took me to the wedding, and there was a big party afterwards with a lot of people who were glad to meet me. I boogied most of the night. Everybody had a really good time.
That's amazing. Have you had many rides, eh?
Oh, yes. People stop and take me along with them as they travel. I have 35,000 friends on my website and Twitter account who are following my travels. They like to see the pictures I'm taking and hear the stories. However, I'm getting a little tired. I need to recharge my batteries. Hitchhiking is tough.
Do you have any other sites you
want to
see,
Ed? Oh, yes. I'm going to tea at the Empress Hotel in Vancouver. Before I go there, though, I've been invited to a First Nation powwow with the people of the Indian tribe.
Wow. You do have a lot of fans. No wonder you need to recharge and rest up, eh? Okay, now I'm going to have to let you off when we get a little closer to Victoria.
That is fine. I will meet more people there, I'm sure. Just remember, I'm a product of human imagination. But my love for humans will never die.
Hitchbot, Canada's first hitchhiking robot, has completed its trip across Canada, arriving in Victoria on July 27th. It hitched 19 rides and spent 21 days exploring Canada. When the robot arrived in Victoria, the mechanical arm was broken and there was a crack on the plastic cake holder that formed its head. But it was otherwise in good shape. The robot's body is now covered in handwritten messages from its fellow travelers, as well as pins and other trinkets it collected along the way.
It is now February 2015. I am excited about the trip I have just completed to Germany. A German broadcasting station flew me to Munich. In just 10 days, I traveled through Cologne, Berlin, and Hamburg. I visited a castle and a cathedral. Many German friends helped me hitch a ride in a sports car, on a bicycle, and I rode a bus. In Cologne, I visited a carnival and was in the Rose Monday Parade. It was wonderful to learn about the German people, culture, and language. My love for humans will never die.
After a long year of hitchhiking and making new friends, Hitchbot was due for another vacation in Europe. It spent 3 weeks traveling around the country, there to fairs and parks and meeting people from all over Europe. Hitchbot reported that in one home in the Netherlands, it hung out with a microwave. This might have been a date. The next planned trip for the hitchhiking robot is to the United States, starting on July 17, 2015, in Salem, Massachusetts.
I am so excited that I get to go to the United States. I can't wait to see the lights in New York City and travel to the Capitol in Washington, D.C. and clear across the country to see the geysers of the Yellowstone. I have a whole list of things to see and do. I was so excited in Boston. I got to attend a game at Fenway Park and wave at crowds. In New York City, I visited Times Square, saw the lights and the excitement there. Now I am in Philadelphia, the city of brotherly love, waiting for my next ride to Washington, D.C., where I want to pose with the Lincoln statue.
Neighborhood establishment where friends gather after work to relax, talk, have a drink, and maybe meet someone new and very interesting.
Can I put that away?
You can.
Yeah. What are the three words? wash my windows.
Well, that does sound like a pretty good price to get all your windows washed. Now, we are pleased to bring a very special surprise guest performer, all the way from Nashville, Tennessee. Please welcome the one, the only, Patsy Cline.
Good evening, everyone. I'm so happy to be here this evening, and I just can't tell you what happened. When we checked in, I found out that my first love of 60 years ago lives over in the flats. Well, I was so surprised. I was so nuts about that guy until that Lucille came along and stole his heart. So, Bob, this is song is for you.
Okay, maestro.
I've got your picture that you gave to me. Your picture, she's got you. I've got the record that we used to share.
Philadelphia, Hitchbot, a hitchhiking robot from Canada, was beheaded and its electronics destroyed.
is an outrage. They should have given guns to this robot to protect himself. He has no protection. Give him guns.
We can't do that. You can't arm robots. What are you thinking about? I think what we need is better borders. You know, fences, and we need to have guards and background checks and visas and things like that. Don't you think that'd work better?
Visas is a robot. He doesn't need a visa.
Well, I guess that's right. But what should we do?
Give him guns. Guns, I say.
Fences. I think fences are better.
No, there's got to be a better solution than that. I think we're going to have to call the Canadians and see if they want the pieces in this pile of junk bag.
Sorry, big fella.
It is 5 months later since my terrible accident in Philadelphia. I am now back home in Toronto with my human family. I'm sorry to say my traveling days are over. My willies are hanging on the wall here. But I'm happy to know that I'll have a permanent home at Ottawa's Science and Technology Museum. My fans can come and visit me there. I will be part of their permanent collection. Just remember, I am a product of human imagination, and my love for humans will never die.
I told you all the events in this story are true and actually happened. If you want to learn more about this unusual story, there's a lot of information and comments about the internet on the internet about these events. We move on now to some of our favorite past performers. The Blonde Girls, who are out for an afternoon drive in their car.
Ooh. Okay, and put the knitting away.
Oh boy.
Kyle won't start. You know what? I'll call Triple M. Hello? Triple M? Yeah, my car won't start. Do you think you could come and look at it? We're at the corner of Grace and First. Okay, thanks. Says he'll be here in a few minutes.
Oh, thank goodness. I'm so glad you remembered your phone, because I forgot mine.
Well, you're blind.
What's the problem?
I don't know. The car won't start. Could you look under the hood and see what's going on?
Pop the hood.
Sure.
Try it.
The blondes are no longer really safe to be out in the car, so they have moved to a bench in a nearby park.
Let's go sit over there. Don't bring her name.
Yeah, you can sit here and knit. Yeah. I'm not driving, so that old cop won't catch us.
Which do you think is further away? Florida or the moon?
Hello? You can see the moon. You can't see Florida. The moon must be closer.
No. Even I know that.
Well, listen, I gotta go. I got some errands to run, so I'll see you later, okay?
Okay, have a good evening. I'm just gonna sit here and enjoy the evening and bye-bye. Didn't end it for a while. This sweater's just taken forever. Just forever. It's too darn hot here for it anyway.
First on the sun.
First on the sun? You cannot go to the sun, it's too hot.
Well, we're not stupid, you know. We're going at night. We do not know if the blondes will actually be able to land on the sun, but at least they are ambitious.
Howdy, folks. My name is Roger. I own 2,500 acres of the finest Texas cattle land you ever seen. I have 1,000 head. I have 1,000 head of the finest beef you ever wanted to taste. And they call my place the Jolly Roger.
My name is John. I have 350,000 acres. and 5,000 head of prime cattle. And they called my place Big John's.
Hi, my name is Richa, and I have 300 acres.
300 acres?
Yes.
What do you grow?
Nothing.
Well, what is it?
Downtown Dallas.
I was at a dance when he caught my eye, standing all alone, looking sad and shy. We began to dance, swaying to and fro. We'll be right back.
get the second half of the show started. Our next series of events all happen in the great state of Texas. Texas, you know, that small, humble, independent country of Texas that in 1845 was willing to admit the rest of the U.S. into their borders and make them all part of the United States. This is a correct map. Texans know the real size of their state. We begin inside a saloon in the Old West in Texas.
Oh, I'll be right back. Yeah, this is where I'm looking for. This is like a pretty nice place. Good look, a look at the girls here. Yeah. Have you got a sarsaparilla?
In a dirty glass.
A dirty glass. Give me one of them sarsaparillas in a dirty glass. I tell you what, I like being down here in Texas. I've been here before, you know. Yeah, it was good, but I had a kind of a problem though the last time I was here. But I think I've got to go check on my horse. I just know I'll be right back. Wait. I'll be right back to see you too. In a short while. What? Hey! What? Did anybody see somebody take my horse? Some polecat took my horse. I tell you what, remember I was telling you about that thing that happened in Texas? I don't want that to ever happen again, but it will. I gotta find my horse. I haven't been in Texas long. You take my horse?
She took it.
She took it?
I saw her right out
of it. I heard she horses around a bit. My horse is gone. I gotta find, you stay right there. Well, you come and stay there. Stop. I gotta go check serious things back. I hate you. You watch her. Oh, I'll be right back. I went to the wrong hitching rail. My horse is already there. I'm so sorry. It was a brown horse, and I thought I'd known the white one. I didn't know. But you're lucky. You are lucky because it could have happened like it happened the last time I was here. I hated that.
What happened the last time you was here?
I had to walk home. It was terrible.
Well, howdy, Lou. How you doing, Lou? It's Luke, isn't it? And Luke, would you mind taking a glass of beer over to Luke over there? I notice he's running out.
Sure.
Thank you kindly.
Give me a Mai Tai. Make it a double.
Well, we don't want your kind in here.
Listen, lady, let me tell you how it's gonna be. The stage Abilene leaves in 15 minutes. I'm gonna be on that stage, but in the meantime, I'm gonna play some cards and I'm gonna enjoy my drink. And if you don't give me any problems, I won't give anybody else any problems. That understood?
Well, see that shit off. I'll be keeping my eye on you.
Two. Three.
The stagecoach is leaving.
Oh, I'm out of here.
Hold it just a minute, Luke.
Whoa. I can't draw.
I know.
Thank you.
just hop on and off and be on my way. Oh no, it's got my toe. Oh no. Oh no. I'm being swallowed by a boa constrictor. Okay, just repeat after me. Oh gee, it's up to my knee.
Oh gee, it's up to my knee.
Oh my, it's up to my thigh.
Oh my, it's up to my thigh.
Oh haste, it's up to my waist.
Oh haste, it's up to my waist.
Crap, it's up to my back.
Crap, it's up to my back.
Oh heck, it's up to my neck. The estate of the King of Obosh in the land of nostalgia. It is many centuries ago when kings and queens reigned in magical lands. It is the story of a princess in that land, Princess Nunsuch.
In the land of nostalgia, there once lived a beautiful princess whose name was Nunsuch. She was known for her beauty, but also for her violent temper and reputation as a shrew. Princes and nobles attracted to her by her great beauty came to woo her, but she spurned them all. Such was her anger at the advances, they fled in dismay. Among her more prominent suitors was a royal family from Chance, whose estates adjoined her father's King Obosh. There were many brothers in the Chance family, and most had been victims of the princess's temper.
The Princess Nunsuch is now 22 years old, which is several years on the shady side of spinsterhood for nostalgias. Recent glances in the mirror revealed new lines on her face, and her once golden hair had darkened. She has reached the point where she longs for romance, but alas, she realizes the bitter truth. Her ungovernable temper has lost her many opportunities. As our story opens, Princess Nunsuch is longing for just one more chance.
It's an early evening in June. The day has been warm and humid, but now a breeze has sprung up and wind is whistling through the trees. And it cools the air. Slowly, the moon rises. Silvery beams on the scene below.
Our princess is alone in this peaceful scene. Romantic thoughts cause her to gaze around wistfully, as if seeking companionship. But sadly, she realizes the fault is her own. Her temper has caused her loneliness. Ah, a bright idea strikes her. She will try it. Closing her eyes and concentrating, she murmurs to herself, "Every day, in every way, I am growing sweeter and sweeter. Every day, in every way, I'm growing sweeter and sweeter." 20 times she repeats the magic formula. And opening her eyes, she is amazed to see that a handsome nobleman has come upon the scene. The princess, her anger aroused by this intrusion, tears across the space. With eyes aflame, she demands his name and business.
My name, fair maiden, is Prince Last Chance, he said. I come from a long line of noble ancestors. I come to ask for your hand. I urge you to take my appeal under consideration.
Your appeal is fruitless, she cried, as she threw it down and strode back and forth with rage. Her anger was very great. I have spurned many of your brothers, she hissed. Must I now humble myself to a last chance?
Keep cool, the prince replied, fair lady. I await your answer.
The princess was about to make an angry reply, but checked herself as she remembered her new resolution. In milder tones, she said, no, prince, I must take my time. Go now. Meet me at this same spot tomorrow at sundown, and you shall receive your answer.
Sighing sadly, he brushed past her and walked woodenly away. He peeled off. He was soon out of sight in the trees.
All was still, not a sound, save the murmuring of the wind through the trees. At last, the pent-up emotions found an outlet, and the tears of the princess fell like hail. Alone in the forest, the princess tries to decide this momentous question. Can she give up her independence for a mere man? And he a last chance? Can she love him enough to look upon his noble face when it needs a shave? Can she bear to hear him slurp soup 365 days a year? On the other hand, can she afford to let this chance pass her by? Her entire future rests upon the decision. Her mind made up, for the fourth time, she returns to the castle.
As for the prince, he arrived home in a troubled state. Couldn't find his home. He arrived home in a troubled state, and the die was cast. What will the morrow bring? Happiness or disappointment? Let us see. Behold, the same scene as yesterday. Prince Last Chance arrives and glances about for the sight of his lady love. But he is alone in his thoughts. Doubts arise. Will she come? Will she accept my offered love? Here's the princess now.
You have come, Prince Last Chance, she says.
Yes, Prince, Princess Nonesuch. I have come once again to press my suit.
Ha 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 ha!
hope it is pleasing to you.
Oh, prince, replies our princess, let us blot out the past and think only of the present.
The present is yours, my princess. I left it in my car. The present is yours, my princess. I hope it fits. Now, let us talk of the future.
If you wish my hand, prince, you must sue for it.
Oh, said the prince, I cannot bring myself to be so cruel. Let's settle this out of court. Come, my lady, the moon rises. And we must go on with the argument.
Very well, responds the princess. As soon as I can pull myself together, you shall have an audience.
If you don't make haste, fair princess, our audience will be bats and beetles and bullfrogs, ribbon.
All right, said the princess, let us make up. Soon, their differences were forgotten. For a moment. Dear prince, said Nonesuch, for she was melting, before I can consider your offer, you must convince me of your fitness to rule.
A light begins to shine on him. That is easy, fair princess. See, I have made a ruler already. As he came toward her with a measured tread, he exclaimed, come, you must decide now or never. 'Tis growing late, and I have been stirring since daybreak. The sun comes up, and he's stirring again. Princess Nonesuch, wilt thou have me?
And she wilted.
So, once again, love triumphs in the end. They may live happily ever after. In the land of nostalgia. I want to introduce the cast to you, and then they will join the Sunshine Dancers, who will lead them and you out to dessert in the back of the room, but you all get to participate in the line dance. First, let me introduce the cast here. In our last skit,